This tutorial covers the steps that primary investigators can perform in the dbGaP registration system. When your study is registered by an NIH Genomic Program Administrator, or GPA, you may receive an invitation to complete the registration for your study in the form of an email with a web link. To demonstrate, I will begin already logged in and on the Submission System page, where I have one registered study. You might see a list of studies. I'll go ahead and click on my example study name. This video essentially carries out the instructions seen here. In the upper right of the page, you see that this study is missing the consent group choices that best describe the consent agreed to by participants in this study. I could go directly to that section by following this consent group link, but I want to briefly review all three sections: study registration information, policy, and consent group. Let's look at the information section first. Please review and edit as needed each of the sections in this page, including information, PI, certification, dbGaP exception, and program officer. Going back up to information, I want to emphasize these target dates. Click in the text area, and a calendar expands to help you select your estimated data delivery date. This is the date you plan to send the data to dbGaP. And the public release date, the date you want dbGaP to release your study. I'm satisfied with the study information page, so I'll scroll down and click Update Study. This takes me back to my Manage Study page, and I'll move down to the Policy section and click Edit. If you want to have your colleagues notified of approved data access request for your study, you can add their email addresses here. You may also add an acknowledgement statement, which you can paste into this field. Please read the helpful tips here, and if necessary, add files such as the submission certification. I'm finished with policy, so I'll click Update Study. The last step is to define the consent categories or groups that best describe the consent agreed to by participants in your study. I'll follow the consent group link to edit that page. In dbGaP, there are four basic consent group types: general research use, which is the broadest consent and covers any research; health, medical, biomedical; disease specific; and other, which should be used only if the other types do not apply. If you are unsure how to fill in this page, click on the help icon, the question mark, which provides a downloadable document that lists each group's options and the text that will be added to the Data Use Limitations field when an option is selected. In this tutorial, I will add three consent groups. The first is general research use. Selecting GRU fills in standard text for the consent group name, abbreviation, and data use limitation. If the consent for participants in your study requires IRB approval from the requesting investigator, select Yes in the dropdown, which adds this text. Checking publication required adds this text, and so on. You may also add comments in the DUL appendix field if needed. You can add any number of consent groups by clicking Add Another Group. I'll select the disease-specific type. The only difference here is that I need to pick a disease from this menu. I will say Yes for IRB approval. Now I want to show one last type, so I'll add another group and select Other. As a PI, you should only select this when none of the other three types can be used for the study. Fill in the empty fields the best you can, and the content will be reviewed by the GPA. These two fields are required, and I need to choose my IRB requirement. Okay, I'm ready to save my entries, so I'll click Update Study. I now see two messages. The top one says that my update was technically successful, but I'm not finished yet. As the warning says, I need to review the three sections in this page and then submit the study for review. I can still review and make changes if I want via the edit buttons. Assuming that I am truly satisfied, I will scroll to the bottom and click Ready for Review by GPA. I am asked if I really meant to hit that button. I'll say OK, and now my page says Ready for Review by GPA, and I can no longer edit these sections, just view them. At this point, the GPA will get an email notification to review and approve your entries. Once the GPA approves the registered study, you will receive an email invitation to the dbGaP submission portal for file submission.